Some asexuals are absolutely happy just being by themselves. Some are in committed relationships, some are married with kids. It's a whole range. The more I thought about it and the more I just thought about sex or really any of those activities in general, the less I was interested the less I found it a requirement for a relationship. So one night I remember drinking a lot. We're at my house, this is gonna happen, but like I just need to just get some liquid courage, if that would help, and just kind of kept drinking. So like my first time, I don't remember a lot of it, but that it was completely fine, it was completely consensual. I just obviously kind of had this nerves of just like, oh my gosh, this is gonna happen. So I just kind of just drank a lot to kind of overcompensate. But I knew I was ready and I knew I wanted to. It just wasn't until it kind of happened that I realized, oh, that was fine. That was okay. But it wasn't, I didn't wake up a new person as a lot of my friends were describing. Respect to my ex and everything like that. It was more like kind of counting the beats and just more looking at the time, I remember. And again, in the nicest way possible, just like, okay. And trying to make sure that, like, I guess the anxieties in my head were very large at the time, of just like, oh, is this right? Is this correct? I'm not sure if I'm doing it right. But I just remember not really getting swept up in the moment or the romance of it, or it was just kind of more, clinical, more just kind of structural and procedural than it was like a wow, like an intimate moment. So I continued with that relationship for another like couple of months, and then we eventually broke things off. Again, very amicable. It was just that I wasn't kind of fulfilling his needs, and I was very clear with myself and said, look, I don't feel that way, you know, like I don't find this a requirement of a relationship, and like I'm happy to work on it, but you're requiring it, you know, so many times. So yeah, so we just kind of, we split that way. After kind of having my first sexual experience, it definitely triggered something in me, because it's like, oh, my life has not changed. My perceptions of like sex and all of that haven't changed either. A lot of my friends were just saying, look, it's not the right person. You got to find someone else. You know, you always have to wait for someone else. Some people spend their lives without a partner. Maybe that's just going to be me. And I kind of resigned myself to that. It wasn't until I found like asexuality or anything, until a YouTube video. I remember one of my YouTubers were talking about how she's asexual and describes like the definition of it. And I'm just like, wow, that is interesting. I'm like, that, I don't think I immediately was like, that's me, but I'm just like, wow, oh, that's, I identify with some of those things. She describes asexuality as kind of a difference between like a romantic and a sexual attraction. How we're always kind of taught that the attraction of like people and others, like if you see someone, wow, I want to, you know, make out with them and I want to have sex with them. Wow, they're so attractive. But how actually for a lot of people, there's a separation between sexual attraction and romantic attraction. So like I can describe it in a way of like my friends like sleeping with guys. They will call themselves heterosexual, but they can also appreciate the beauty of like some of the women, you know, will walk around being like, oh my God, she's stunning. Doesn't mean they want to sleep with her. And she spoke about that in the video, and I'm just like, oh, wow, that's interesting. And she kind of described of how asexuals have like a pretty like little to no desire for any like kind of sexual activity or anything to do with that. And I said, oh, that's me. Like I have a little bit of desire, but not like a huge amount. So there's a term for that. So gray sexuals, so gray asexuals means it's almost like a spectrum. So it's like, okay, some people can have a little bit, you know, can view people somewhat sexually, but not most of the time. It's not a majority. And I'm like, oh, maybe that's me. That was like a good entry point into, yeah, the asexual world. I didn't want to give myself that term because I didn't think I deserved it, which was interesting because obviously labels are so powerful.
Why did you think that you didn't deserve the label?
It's a great question. I think because maybe I felt like I was like a fraud, or maybe because like I had been sexually active in the past. And I feel like a lot of the times, sometimes like the more toxic side of the LGBTQIA+ community is there's a lot of gatekeeping. So I just felt and it was all internalized. Like, I never like wrote anything, and everyone's like, no, you don't belong. But it was just very much like this internalized fear and this internalized kind of like almost hatred of just like, no, I don't think I deserve to call myself that.
When you came out to your family and friends, how did they take it?
The thing is, I didn't realize about kind of coming out is you're always coming out. You're constantly coming out to people. So it's just this kind of constant state of being like almost like a representative for this label as well, which is sometimes scary. But yeah, like even even last night, a good friend, I told her I was doing this today, and I came out to her, and I tried to make it as natural as possible, because again, I feel that the more we talk about this, the better it is.
Is it tiresome to always be talking about it?
Oh my gosh, it's so tiresome, yes, because sometimes you just don't want to explain the whole minutiae of asexuality or just even just your sexuality. And sometimes it's to a person that maybe you don't know super well, but now you have to explain your entire life to, your entire like sexual history to, because they ask you so many questions. So sometimes it is tiresome. Like I said, it's not just like, I'm gay and then, you know, full stop. There's always an asterisk, I feel like, with asexuality.